Welcome back to Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanjuatco Trillo. One man's junk may be another man's treasure, or in this case, a woman's treasure. Charisse Padilla, co-owner of Anak ng Kwek, has been turning junk items into wearable pieces for almost 3 years now. Hello, Charisse.
Hi.
Hi. Okay, tell me a little bit about how Anak ng Kwek started.
Okay, my partner and I, Paula Reyes, we were thinking of a venture and extra money, but we didn't have the capital to start one. So we're thinking, what should we do? Mm-hmm. Well, one thing, we're good in arts, so we're thinking art merchandise, but again, we don't have the capital to source out the materials. So we started at home, what's readily available, which is junk. So there it is.
All the stuff that would otherwise get thrown out. So
yes.
You make accessories, necklaces, mm-hmm. Earrings, that mm-hmm. sort of thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but how do you balance that with the fact that you and your partner both have full-time day jobs?
Well, it's more of an outlet, not a full-fledged business.
Okay.
So it's a creative outlet that will suffice the hunger of individuality of artists and musicians and all those who wants to be unique.
Right, because you don't really make more than one or two of each
yes,
item or each product,
it's not
right?
mass-produced, actually.
Right. So up to now, you still use the junk around the house, or do you get materials from other places?
We often have donations. Like after a certain election, there's one bag of baller IDs.
Oh,
so we got a donation from that. So we turned that into a bracelet or a necklace.
Okay, the only limit being your imagination, I guess. But all of these are handmade.
Yes.
So how much time do you spend a day or a week creating this stuff? Because I'm assuming it's just you and your partner who make them, right?
Sometimes my mother helps out.
Oh, mom helps
friends,
too.
Boyfriends.
Yeah, make them work, right?
Yeah.
But how many man hours is that, would you say?
It really depends. We don't have a pattern on each item, so it depends on the intricacy of the item.
Okay, and does your background in web design and graphic design help you a lot in what you're doing?
Well, maybe, yeah. At some point, we knew how to market it,
uh-huh.
to, and how to be creative about it, yeah.
Okay, and tell us how the name Anak ng Kwek came about.
Well, I was eating kwek when I thought of it, and then we're thinking of something quirky and funny, mm-hmm. and Anak ng Kwek came out as an expression.
Okay.
So whenever they see a fastener earring, Anak ng Kwek, this is a fastener, it's an earring, or
right,
something
right,
like that.
Right. Cool. Okay, so who are your usual customers? Who are the people who usually buy from you?
Mostly women, students, artists, musicians. Yeah.
And people who just want uniquely
yes,
things, right?
Exactly.
How much do your accessories cost?
From 50 pesos to 300.
Wow, so 300 is already like pretty much the max
yes.
in your menu.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And where do you sell these?
Online at Facebook and Multiply, and we also have consignments at CCP Gift Shop and Cubao.
Oh, okay. So they're available pretty much everywhere. I think would you say online is stronger or has better sales than the, you know, the physical stores?
No. Bazaars, actually.
The bazaars are good. Yeah, everybody loves
the
bazaars, right? But isn't that hard if it's not the Burr months and there aren't too many bazaars happening?
Yeah, it's hard. Usually at peak seasons, like December.
Right. Okay. And what advice would you have to give, young people like yourself who want to start a business but don't have the capital? What could you tell them?
Start at home, start what's readily available, start with whatever your edge is.
Right, yeah. And for you guys, that's the arts, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay, look at the faces of these people at your stall. They're
yeah.
really fascinated
yeah.
with your stuff. What I'm fascinated with, though, is your necklace.
Oh.
Is that a real mousetrap?
Yes, it's real.
Okay.
I don't sell it, though.
Okay, that's uniquely for the proprietors of Anak ng Kwek-Kwek. But you had that lying around the house and you decided to just make it a necklace.
Yes, it's clean.
It's clean. And
no one's ever
tied there yet. But have you done something to it so it doesn't snap when you hold it?
It's actually broken, so I turned it into a pendant.
Okay. Yeah, I would have never thought of making that.
Even this, I made this.
Okay, what's that? That looks like it's from a jacket.
From a jeans.
Okay, from like the waist part of the jeans,
you just
cut it up.
Mm-hmm.
Fabulous. All right, you have more stuff on the table. Maybe you can just narrate to us exactly what you brought.
Okay, we mostly brought junk.
Junk.
Okay. Because we have three collections.
Okay.
Three major collections.
All right.
One is happy beads. These are hand-drawn beads made into...
Okay, just with happy faces and you added the bodies with different beads. And that's a necklace, right?
Yes.
How much is that going for?
100, 150.
Oh, okay. What else do you have?
And then isaware, taken from the famous street food, isaw. So we use different wires. For this is copper wire. This is phone cable wire. So these are...
Oh, wow. Where do you get the phone cable wire from?
Broken phones.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. And then finally, of course, junk quick. So these are the junks, fasteners.
Okay.
Fasteners.
When you say fasteners, what is it fastened? Like for paper?
Yeah. Paper fasteners.
Oh, which you turned into earrings.
Yes.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I would probably say anak ng kwek-kwek too if I
for high end bazaars we usually get OMG.
Oh my gosh. Really say that when they're shopping. Okay, whatever.
And cassette tapes.
Okay.
Those are worn
as like pendant necklaces now.
Even in the insides of the cassette tapes, so these are pendants.
Can I see what is that? Ah, okay, like the roll part in it.
Yes.
Oh my goodness. Okay, really, like no limits.
Oh, this is popular. The glue tubes.
Earrings.
Yeah.
Wow, you need somebody really fashion forward. to wear those.
And then electronic parts, like end of the keyboard.
Oh, okay. Yeah, exactly.
Microchips, keyboard. Right. So these are all necklaces.
Okay, and these are just all from the house that you can use. All right.
Sorry.
How do you think? What do you think will happen with Anak ng Kwek-Kwek looking forward?
Well, ultimately, we plan to have a store. So that's every entrepreneur's dream.
To have like a bricks and mortar store, not just be online. If people want to donate their stuff to you, you know, the little junk or broken phones or old cassette tapes they have in their house, can they donate it to you? Would you accept them?
Sure, definitely.
Okay, so how would they do that? They just need to get in touch with you online?
Okay. I believe it's posted on the screen.
It's on there. Okay, so just through Facebook, they can send you a message. Mm-hmm. And I have some junk for you. Would you like it?
Gladly.
Okay, what if you have special requests from customers? Do you make custom-made accessories?
Yes, we do, but we're having a hard time sourcing out the materials.
Oh, okay. So it would depend on if the particular material were available.
Yeah, exactly. Since it is junk, so it is very limited.
What would you say are some of the most unusual requests you've had for bespoke items?
Well, nothing really, because everything is very unusual. so everything's normal.
The normal has become unusual.
Yeah.
Right? Okay, well, you have some fascinating things here. All of these things are pictured online, right? So if people want to have a look, they can just go to Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do you ever worry about running out of ideas? Or have you ever looked at an object and said, I cannot possibly turn this into some kind of accessory?
We don't push it hard, so skip to another material.
Oh, okay. So it's that sort of how you deal with the creativity
block. No pressure.
No pressure. Just keep enjoying what you're doing.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Well, Charisse, I know they call you Chung.
Yes.
Right. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
For coming on Shop Talk. Please invite everyone to get your products.
Visit our Facebook page, Anak ng Kwek-Kwek. It's facebook.com/anak ng Kwek-Kwek, and then we have a multiply also. And you can contact me at 0927-468-7711 or email us at anaknangkwek@gmail.com.
That's right. And even if you don't want to buy anything, if you want to donate junk to Chung and her partner, then you can do so as well, right?
Mm-hmm. And we're also open for collaborations.
Oh, yeah. Nice, nice. All right. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
Thank you so much.
Okay, and thank all of you for watching Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanjuatco Trillo. Please follow ANC Shop Talk on Twitter and be a fan of ANC Shop Talk on Facebook. Enjoy the rest of your day.